Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the surface areas and volumes. In generally, in our daily life, we are observing so many objects around us. Suppose now you are using the writing on the paper. What is the shape of the paper? Yes, right. It is in the shape of rectangle. So how can we draw the rectangle on the board? That is, this is the rectangle we can draw on the board. Rectangle means, what does it have? How many measurements it have? So it has length and the breadth. This is the length of the rectangle. This is the breadth of the rectangle. And some objects may have the square shape, that is all sides are equal, then it is called the square. So it has again two sides, all sides are equal, therefore it is denoted by S. And some other may have the shape of triangle or the shape of circle. If you observe all these objects, these are having the length and breadth, these have the length and breadth, and it is occupying, these are occupying some space, that is occupying some area. So length and breadth, it is a side and side, therefore all, if you observe, all these objects are two dimensions, because they have the only two lengths and breadth, that's why they are called the two dimensional objects. Similarly, in our daily life, we can observe the different type of objects. So for example, if we take that, suppose I have an object, can you recognize this? What is this? Right, correct. It is a cuboid. How can we draw the cuboid on the board? So if you want to draw the cuboid on the board, we can draw like this. This is the cuboid. Means what does it have? It has a length and it has a breadth. This is the length. Consider this is the length. And this is the breadth B. And this is the height H. This is length means this is also length. This is the breadth means this is also breadth. So this cuboid has how many faces? This has a 6 faces. Let us see. Front side 1, back side 2, right side 3, left side 4, upside 5, downside 6. This has a cuboid has the 6 faces. These 6 faces are in the shape of A. It is the rectangle shape, and this is also in the shape of rectangle. This is also in the shape of rectangle. This is also in the shape of rectangle. What about these two? These two are in the shape of a square. So in our daily life, we are using that so many, we can observe so many objects like this form. Suppose, if you want to pack this item, you can observe in the gift shops. They want to pack this item, then they have to find the total surface area, because they have to cover total paper. That's why they have to find the total surface area. Actually, they are not finding, without finding, they are simply measuring, they are folding the paper, they are packed. But here we have to discuss, we have to know about the total surface area of the cuboid. So how can we get that total surface area? That is nothing but, how many faces does it have? It has the 6 faces. So each face is in the shape of either rectangle or square. So let us observe that, suppose if we take this face, this is the length and this is the height. So it is in the form of a rectangle form. We know already what is the area of rectangle. Area of rectangle is, right, very good, length into breadth. So length in place of breadth, it is h. So we can write this is the area of one face is lh, and exactly opposite to this face is also having the same length and same height, therefore it is also area lh. If you observe this area, it is L and it is B. Then the area of this face is L into B. Exactly same back side is also there, that is also L into B. That's why another area of another face is LB plus LB. What about the this side? It has the edge height and it is the base B. So area of this is BH. Same BH is opposite side is also there. Therefore, the sum of two sides is BH plus BH. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 faces are there, area of 6 faces. Sum of the area of 6 faces is nothing but the total surface area of the cuboid. So how? We can write the formula, that is the total surface area of cuboid is equal to, how many times there? 2 times. This is also LB also 2 times, BH also 2 times. Therefore, I am taking the 2 common. 2 into LB plus BH plus LH. This is the total surface area of the cuboid. This is the formula for the total surface area of the cuboid. Suppose this is our classroom. If you want to paint the 4 sides of the walls, 4 sides of the room, then we have to measure only the 4 sides area of the 4 walls. 4 walls means suppose this is the room. 4 walls means what we should consider only 4 faces. This is called the lateral surface area of the cuboid. So lateral surface area means how many faces we are considering here? Only 4 faces. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we should consider only 4 faces. That is called the lateral surface area of the cuboid. That is lateral surface area of cuboid equal to how many? Only 4 faces. That is 2H into L plus B. That is we are taking only 2LH to BH. Therefore we are taking common 2H, therefore 2H into L plus B. This is called the lateral surface area of the cuboid. Lateral surface area of the cuboid. And I have the another object, that is, see what is this? Can you say what is this? Yes, right. This is the cube. So what is the difference between the cube and cuboid? This cube and cuboid. Cuboid has the 3 different lengths. That is, the length is different, breadth is different, height is different. But when you come to the cube, all the sides are equal. That is the length, breadth and height. All the sides are equal. Let it be S, side denoted by S. And if you observe the face, this face is in the shape of square. Already we know, what is the area of the square? Right, area of the square is side into side. That is S square. If you want to find the total surface area of the cube, how many faces we have to add? Just 6 faces are there. We should add 6 faces. Therefore, area of first face is S square. Then all the sum of the all the areas of this all faces, sum of the area of all faces, that is 6 times. Therefore, we can write the formula, that is total surface area of cube equal to 6S square. Similarly, you can say, now what is the lateral surface area of the cube? Yes, right. Lateral surface means it should have the only 4 faces. Therefore, each face has the area S square. Therefore, lateral surface area of cube equal to 4S square. It is the lateral surface area of the cube and total surface area of the cube, lateral surface area of the cuboid, total surface area of the cuboid. Next, what about that? It has a another, that is a, we have discussed that value. What about the value? Volume of the cuboid. Volume of the cuboid equal to volume. Value means what? The object, which object is it? This object is occupying some area in the space. That space is called the volume of the cuboid. How can we find the volume of the cuboid? By multiplying the length and the breadth and height. Therefore, volume of the cuboid we can write as volume of the cuboid equal to length into breadth into height, L into B into H. Similarly, we can find the, can you say the volume of the cube? Volume of cube equal to, in place of L, what is the side? Volume of cube in place of the side S. That is S into S, that equal to S cube, right? Very good. S cube, volume of the cube equal to S cube. So this is the lateral surface area, total surface area, and the volume of the cube and cuboid. Next, let us discuss that prism. What is a prism? Prism means, how can you say that prism? Prism means the top and the bottom of the objects should be concrete sides, and the side should be in the shape of either rectangle or square. So I think this is satisfying the same properties. That is, base has in the shape of a square and top is also in the shape of a square, and the sides are in the shape of a rectangle. Therefore, we can say that cuboid is a prism. Cuboid is also a prism. So similarly, can you say, is it a prism? Right, yes, this is also a prism, because it is also satisfying the same conditions. Top and bottom are the concrete sides, and side faces are in the shape of a square. Therefore, it is also a prism. So all these are prisms only, and I will show another type of prism to you. Let us see this. This is also a prism. What is the shape of the top? In the shape of a triangle. What is the shape of the bottom? Very good, triangle. So both are congruent. And what about the side faces? It is in the shape of a rectangle. Therefore, it is also a prism. It is called a triangular prism, because the depend on the base, we can divide that which type of prism is that. It is a base is in the shape of a triangle, therefore it is called the triangular prism. Suppose already we discussed here lateral surface area of the cuboid, total surface area of the cuboid. Next, lateral surface area of the cube, total surface area of the cube, and volume of the cuboid, volume of the cube. So already we discussed these formulas. Now, by the definition of the prism, we accepted these two also a prisms. So by using this formula, how can you find the volume or lateral surface area of the prism? Lateral surface area of the prism is, what is it? 2h into l plus b for the cuboid particular prism. So we can conclude and we can generalize that area of the lateral surface area of the prism equal to lateral surface area of prism equal to, what is that here? 2 into L plus B. Suppose if we consider as the prism, this base is in the shape of a rectangle. This is the base of a rectangle. What is that 2 into L plus B means? What you are remaining? This is the perimeter of the base. That is, lateral surface area of prism equal to perimeter of base. Perimeter of base into height. Perimeter of base into height. What is the perimeter? Suppose it is a cuboid. Perimeter means 2 into L plus B. That is the perimeter. What is the height? Height is H. Therefore, perimeter of base into height, we can consider that for all the prisms, it is applicable. Lateral surface area of prism is always perimeter of base into height. Next, if you consider the volume of the prism, volume of the prism,
we discussed here, value of the prism equal to, what is that L into B into H? What is L into B? If it is the base, L into B means that is the area of rectangle, area of the base. Therefore, what we can generalize the formula, area of base into height of the prism. Height of the prism. So, area of the base into height of the prism, then we will get that volume of the prism. So, this is the, all these are prisms. Some prisms are, that is, in particular prism, this is called the cuboid and this is called the cube and this is called the triangular prism. All are prisms only, but depend on the base, we are calling the some other names. Now, come to our textbook. See, in this first problem is there, do this. Find the total surface area and lateral surface area of the cube with the side 4 cm. You writing, I am not giving the time. You can pause the video and you can write that. So that's why I am not giving the particular time to write down the note of these problems. So see this first problem, what is that given? Find the total surface area, lateral surface area of the cube with the side 4 cm. That is side of a cube is equal to 4 cm. What we should find? Find the total surface area and lateral surface area. So, lateral surface area of cube equal to, just now discussed, what we discussed, what is the formula? Right. Lateral surface area of the cube equal to 4s square. What is s here? S equal to 4. Sum should be done. 4 into 4 square. That is, 4 square is 16. 16 4s. 64. Centimeter squares are square centimeters. This is the lateral surface area of the cube. Next, total surface area of cube is, what is the formula? Total surface area? Very good. 6s square, that is 6 into 4 square, that is 6 into 4 square is 16. 16 6, 96 square centimeters. It is the total surface area and lateral surface area of the cube. And see this, it is given here, try this is given there. Find the volume of the cube whose edge is A. How it is given? In place of S, what we considered the edge is S. In place of S, it is given as A. Then what is the volume of the cube? That is A cube, already we discussed now. Next in that B is there, find the edge of a cube whose value is 1000 centimeter cube. Value of cube equal to 1000 centimeter cube. What is the formula, value of the cube formula what? Volume of cube, formula of volume of cube is S cube. Therefore, S cube equal to 1000 centimeter. Then what we can write 1000 as? Right, very good. We can write as 10 cube. S equal to then 10 centimeters. That is, edge of a cube equal to 10 centimeters. This is our required answer. Next, some other problems are given there. Do this is there.
Simply you can try this. Find the volume of the cuboid if length L equal to 12, breadth B equal to 10 and height H equal to 8. So let us do this. Length of the cuboid. L equal to, what is given there? 12 centimeters. Breadth of cuboid. B equal to, what is given there? 10 centimeters. Height of the cuboid. H equal to 8 centimeters. Height of the cuboid H equal to 8 centimeters. What do you find? Volume of the cuboid. Volume of cuboid B equal to, what is the formula? Right, very good. L into B into H. What is L? 12 into 10 into 8. 12 8s. 96 tens, 960 cubic centimeters or centimeter cube. Cubic centimeters are centimeter cube. Now, next. Second problem is there. Find the value of the cube if its edges is 10 centimeters. Now, you do this. Only edges is given 10 centimeters. Then volume of the cube. What is the volume of the cube? Right, S cube. That is what is given there at 10 centimeters. Therefore, we can do as 10 into 10 into 10. How much it will be? 1000 cubic centimeters. Now, observe the third one. Find the volume of isosceles right angle triangular prism. Isosceles right angle triangular prism. Are we discuss isosceles right angle triangle prism? Volume of the prism. What is the volume of the prism? Yes, we discussed now. No? Volume of the prism equal to area of base into height. What is it given? Length of triangular prism. L equal to 8 centimeters. Breadth of triangular prism B equal to 5 centimeters. Height of triangular prism H equal to 5 centimeters. Did you observe there? In the figure it is given that 5 centimeters, 8 centimeters and 5 centimeters. Now, what is the base here? If you observe that base of the prism is in the shape of rectangle. Base of the prism is in the shape of rectangle. Actually, what is our formula? Volume of prism equal to area of base into height. Area of base into height. What is the area? Area is in the shape of rectangle. Therefore, what is the area of the rectangle formula?
Right,
length into breadth. What is length here? 8 into what is breadth here? 5. 8 into 5. And height, what is the height here? 5. So, 8 5s, 40. 40 5s, 200, right? 200 centimeter cube. This is the volume of the given triangular prism. See there, did you listen that pyramid word? Did you see that pyramid? Some people are doing yoga under the pyramid. And in the Egypt, there are so many pyramids out there. You can observe that pyramid shape. How it will be pyramid shape? The base, see, I am showing that this is the pyramid. This type of shape is called the pyramid. What is its properties? So, what is the difference between the prism and the pyramid? So now I will show the difference between the prism and the pyramid. This is the prism, this is the pyramid. What I said, that property of prism is base and height should have the triangular. Base and height should have the concurrent sides. Here it is the base. Base and height should have the concurrent sides, and the side faces are in the shape of a rectangle. But if you come to the pyramid, base is in the shape of a square and the sides are in the shape of a triangles, because there is no height, there is no space in the top. It becomes as a point. So this is called the pyramid. So pyramid means, what is the difference between the pyramid and the prism? There is given in your book, textbook, one activity is given there. What is that? Volume. You can take the pyramid and the prism having the same height and the, having the same base, like this. The base should have the same and height should have the same height. By taking that type, you can take any liquid or solid. Take that, fill that prism and pour into the pyramid. Take with the pyramid and pour into the prism. How many times? If you fill 3 times, then it will be filled. That is, you can do that activity as given in the book. Then from that, what you can observe, that it is that from the activity we can observe that volume of the prism is 3 times the volume of the pyramid. Therefore, what we can write, that volume of pyramid is equal to 1/3 of volume of prism. 1/3 of volume of prism. So directly we can say that volume of the pyramid equal to 1/3 of volume of prism. That is the relation between the pyramid and the prism. So now here activity is given. By doing that activity, you can observe that and one more problem is given there. Do this. Find the volume of the pyramid whose square base is 10 cm and height is 8 cm. The pyramid is, pyramid base is in the shape of a square. That is, side of a square base equal to 10 cm, height of a pyramid equal to 8 cm. Height of pyramid equal to 8 cm. What about find volume of the pyramid? Volume of pyramid equal to 1/3 into, what is the value of the prism? That is that value of the pyramid equal to 1/3 into, value of pyramid means what? Already discussed, value of prism. Volume of prism is area of the base into height. So 1/3 into area of base into height. Area of base into height. What is that? 1/3 into area of base. Base is in the form of a square. Therefore, Area of square is 10 into 10. That is, area of base is side into side, 10 into 10. Into height, what is height? 8. That is, 10 into 10, 100 into 8, 800. 800 by 3 cubic centimeters or centimeter cube. This is the volume of the pyramid. Come to the exercise 10.1. See the first problem. Find the lateral surface area and the total surface area of the following prisms. Just now we done that in the example problem. Lateral surface area, by using the formula directly you can substitute there. First problem it is given that 4 cm and lateral surface area and volume. So lateral surface area and the total surface area of the following prisms. First one is given that cube and second one is given that cuboid. Next, I am going to solve that second problem. The total surface area of the cube is 1350 square meters. Find its value.
Total surface area of cube equal to 1350 square meters.
What is the total surface area of the cube formula?
Right.
According to formula, total surface area of cube equal to 6s square.
Therefore,
equation 6s square equal to 1350. S square equal to 1350 by 6. 6 ones, 6 twos 12, 6 twos 12, 6 fives 30. That is, S square equal to 225. S equal to under root of 225. We can write as 225 as 15 square. Therefore, S equal to 15 meters. This is the side of a cube. Next, see there, the third problem is that, let us see the third problem. See what's the third problem? Find the area of four walls of your room. Assume that there are no doors or windows. If it is length is 12 cm, 12 meters, breadth 10 meters, height is 7.5 meters. So, what is given? Length of a room equal to 12 meters. Breadth of a room. Length of a room L equal to 12 meters. Breadth of a room B equal to 10 meters. Height of the room. Height of a room H equal to 7.5 meters. What do I find? Find the area of four walls of a room. So what is the four walls of a room formula? That is the four walls of a room is what do I have to find? We have to find the lateral surface area of room. What is the lateral surface area of the room? Lateral surface area of cuboid. The root is because it is given that length and breadth and height is different. Therefore, we can consider as a cuboid. Lateral surface area of cuboid equal to 2h into l plus b. Then, what is the height? 2 into h is 1.5 into l plus b. What is l? 12 plus 10. That is 2 into 7.5. How much it will be? Right, very good. 15. 15 into 12 plus 10. Right, 20. Now, product of 15 into 20. How much it will be? Very good. 330 square meters. It is the lateral surface area, that are the area of the four walls is, area of the four walls is 330 square meters. Now, let us see the fourth problem. Volume of the cuboid is 1200 centimeter cube. Length is 50 centimeters and breadth is 10 centimeters. Find its height. So here it is given value.
Value of cuboid V equal to,
value of the cuboid equal to
1200 centimeter cube.
The length is 15 centimeters.
Length of cuboid equal to 15 centimeters.
Breadth of the cuboid is 10 centimeters.
We have to find the height. Height of the cuboid, let me equal to h.
What we know the formula? Right, very good. That is, value of the cuboid equal to